Today, I'll show you a tour of Microsoft Stream, a new enterprise video solution built on Microsoft Azure that allows you to deliver dynamic and secure video engagement for your organization. I'll show you how you get started with the upload experience, the integrated Office 365 experiences, unique intelligence capabilities such as speech-to-text and face detection, and keep watching as I'll also show you how Stream works and the governance model behind it. When we set out to design Microsoft Stream, we wanted to deliver an intuitive experience that was both familiar and easy to use and highly consumable within the context of applications people work in, all while being able to leverage the scale, intelligence, and security of the Microsoft Cloud. Once you're signed into Office 365, you can get to Stream directly from the App Launcher or the Waffle. So you can click on the Stream tile and you can get to the Stream homepage. Whether your goal is to amplify corporate communications, knowledge share, or just to improve overall team collaboration with visual media, our goal is to give you a fast, secure way to discover, publish, share, and consume video inside your organization. The first thing you see when you log into Microsoft Stream is the videos trending around you. Just below that, you'll see the tutorial videos, so you can learn how to get started with Stream. And then Stream has channels, and just below that, what you see are channels you are following. This is an easy way for you to get to the new content in those channels. Then, as you go below the page, you also see popular channels, as well as some other trending videos inside the organization. Uploading a video is a familiar experience. Let's take a scenario. I have a video for an upcoming release that I want to share with the team I'm working with. I'll click on Upload in the nav bar or Create and Upload a Video. At this point of time, I'll drag and drop the video I wanted to share with my team. Stream will automatically pick a thumbnail for you, and you can create your own thumbnail as well. By default, this video is open to everybody in the organization, and I do want anyone to be able to search for it and find it, so I'm going to leave this checkbox checked. Stream has groups that are associated with office groups. So since I want to share this video with the marketing group, I'm going to look for the marketing group and add it to a product launch videos channel inside that. I can also make this group the owner so that other people can edit the video. And that's it. Then I can go ahead and publish my video, and it's ready. And now that my video is ready, it can also be consumed within the Office 365 app experiences that me and my colleagues may be using, such as OneNote, Sway, Yammer, Teams, and SharePoint. For example, my team often collaborates in Microsoft Teams, and I have a marketing team inside Teams. And what I've done is I've added a tab for all the videos that are part of my channel in this team, so my colleagues can actually watch the video in line within Teams. And here is the video I just uploaded, so clicking on it will actually play it back, and my team can have a conversation around this. As this is a launch, I'm also setting up a SharePoint communication site. Now, with a simple web part, I have added all my launch videos to the site, so that I can share broadly with everyone in the company. This is why I had marked my video as public earlier. And now let me show you my favorite feature in Stream. With intelligence in the form of automatically converting speech to text and making it search, Stream can find videos that had no metadata in them, and not only that, it highlights the time within the video where it appeared. Let me try to search for suspicious activity. And what you see here is it found a video which had no description related to suspicious activity, but it found it because somebody said suspicious activity somewhere in the video. If I click on this, it will take me to that video and take me to that point in the video so that I can start watching from there. From here, I'm in complete control. I can actually search for more terms in the transcript, click anywhere in the transcript to go to that point in the video. I can also click on one of the faces to see where this person was speaking in the video next and go to that point in the video. Stream also generates automatic closed captions using the speech to text, so I can just turn the closed caption on at any point of time and make my videos available to more people in the org. Finally, all viewers, as I said, are always in control. If I want to watch this video fast or slow, I can simply change the playback speed and watch it at my own pace. That was your experience as a user. Now as an admin, Stream meets Office 365 compliance standards, so you can rely on it, and we know it's important that you're able to govern the solution. I can click on my profile here and go to the admin settings page. From here, I can add other people as admins. I can restrict commenting on the videos. I can even restrict who can upload to the videos. And we have a workflow built in where if I had a company policy, I could actually specify that here and toggle the switch on so that everybody has to accept the policy before they upload the videos. If I'm looking to manage the groups, I can actually go to the Office Groups admin experience and manage it from there. Finally, I can also elevate myself to manage videos and channels from others in the organization. I can update the metadata, I can add additional owners, I can turn the comments off, and I can even delete the video. Next, let's see how Stream works behind the scenes. When you log into Stream using your organization account, you're authenticated with Azure Active Directory. You are then able to upload your video content using the Stream interface that runs as an Azure web role. From there, Microsoft Stream talks to Azure Media Services and the Blob service and uploads your video to Azure Blobs. Media Services then encodes the content, produces different resolution, compresses and analyzes the caption, applies face recognition with Azure Media Analytics, and sends the collected metadata to Azure SQL. And as Stream is a global service, it utilizes Traffic Manager to direct people to the closest location to view the content. Then as a viewer, you can log in with an organization account and you can watch video directly from Stream or within your favorite Office 365 app. So that was a quick tour of Microsoft Stream. To get started, you can visit stream.microsoft.com or you can go to Stream from your app launcher in Office 365. Thanks for watching.